योर क्वेश्चन इज पी इज द पॉइंट माइनस फोर कॉमा टू एंड क्यू इज द पॉइंट फाइव कॉमा माइनस फोर. अ लाइन एल इज ड्रॉन थ्रू पी एंड परपेंडिकुलर टू पी क्यू टू मीट द वाई एक्सिस एट अ पॉइंट आर. तो वॉट ही हैज टोल्ड जस्ट वी हैव टू रीड इट एंड वी हैव टू मेक इट. तो दे हैव टोल्ड यू हियर दे हैव गिवन यू वाई एक्सिस. तो नाउ आवर कोऑर्डिनेट आर हाउ वी कैन ड्रॉ लाइक दिस. तो दिस इज योर वाई एक्सिस एंड दिस इज योर जेड एक्सिस, सॉरी एक्स एंड वाई. तो एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस. नाउ वॉट दे हैव टोल्ड जस्ट वी हैव टू गो फॉर दैट. P is the point, is this the point and Q is the point this. So there are two points. So suppose this is the point. This is P and this is your Q. So P is minus 4 comma 2. And Q is 5 comma minus 4. Next, what they are told? A line L is drawn through P and perpendicular to PQ. Through PQ is perpendicular. That means that line is like this. Perpendicular to here. It forms 90 degree here. So this is the line. To meet y-axis at a point R. Y-axis at a point R. Now your question will start. Okay. So what they have told? See that. Find the equation of the line L. This is your line L. Now, so what we have to do? Equation of the line L. That means this is perpendicular to this. So first we will find out the gradient. So suppose the gradient of this is M1. And this is your M2. So gradient formula is what? M is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this is the gradient formula. So we know the coordinate of this. So just we will go for that. So now you can see if you substitute the value, what you will get? Minus 4 minus 2 by 5 minus of minus 4 is plus 4. 5 plus 4. That is equal to minus 6 by 9. If you cut it, you will get minus 3 by minus 2 by 3. So this is the gradient of this. Minus 2 by 3. If M1 is minus 2 by 3 and L is the perpendicular line, that is M2. So what is the gradient of that? We know that the product of two gradient, they are perpendicular to each other, then their product is minus 1. Therefore, M2 is what? See this. Minus 1, that means here minus is there. So we will write plus. And this is 2 by 3. So we will write 3 by 2. So M2 is 3 by 2. This one is 3 by 2. Hmm? Now, we know that this is on y-axis. On y-axis, what happened? Y is varying. And x is constant, that is 0. So we will write y, 0. 0, y, sorry. So here the coordinate of r is 0, y. So first we will find out this. What we will get? The slope. So here m2 is 3 by 2. That is equal to, what is that? 2 minus y by minus 4 minus 0, that means minus 4. Cross multiply that. What we will get? Here we will get 4 minus 2y is equal to minus 12. So now, bring this 4 to this side, it will be minus 4. So here it will be minus 2y is equal to minus 16. Minus and minus gone. So y is equal to 8. So now the coordinate is 0, 8. So we have found out first what? Coordinate B. That is your 0, 8. Now we will find out the equation of the line L. So what is the formula for two-point method? That is nothing but what? Y minus y1, y minus y1, that is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. So we know that this is the slope y2 minus y1. That is what? 3 by 2. And this is our first coordinate. We know that y means we have already taken that 2 minus y. So this is your x1, y1. X1, y1. Now substitute the values. What we will get? We will get y minus y1. Y1 is 2. That is equal to, this is your m2. That is your 3 by 2. Into x minus x1. That is minus of minus 4. That is plus 4. Cross multiply it. So here what you will get? See that? We will get 2y minus 4 is equal to 3x plus 12. Bring this minus to this side. And this everything to your right side. What you will get? We will get 3x minus 2y. That and plus 16. That is equal to 0. Or if you want to write in your y is equal to mx plus c, you can write it. Y is equal to mx plus c. So what we have to do, just we have to keep y here. Remaining we have to bring this side. So what is that? Mx. So m we know that. So that means, what is that? Here you will get minus 2y is equal to minus 3x minus 16. Everywhere minus is there. So we will cancel it. So it will become a plus. And here 2 is there. So here what it will be? 3x by 2 plus 16 by 2. That is equal to, therefore, y is equal to 3x by 2 plus 8. So you can write any one of the equation. Next, find the area of a triangle PQR. P, Q and R. Like this. So we have to find out the area. So we know that here it forms what? 90 degree. Therefore, the area of a triangle is half into B base into height. So this will become, PR will become base and PQ will become your height. So by the distance formula we can go for that. Or you can go for your area of a triangle by three coordinates. So now we will go for a distance formula. So what is your distance formula? That we will write. So distance formula is what? Root over x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So first we will find out RP or PR. So what it will be? PR. That is equal to root under. Now go for that. 8 minus, sorry, 0 minus of minus 4 is plus 4. So 4, 4 square. Plus, next 8 minus 2 is 6, 6 square. So what we will get? Root over 16 plus 36. That is equal to 52, root 52. Root 52. Next. Next we will go for, and root 52 value is what? 13 into 4. 13 into 4. 12, 1. That means you will get 2 root 13. So this is equal to 2 root 13. Unit. Next we will go for PQ. PQ. Root over. Next. See that. What is that? 5 minus of minus 4 is plus 4. That means 9. So 9 square. Plus minus 4 minus 2 is minus 6. Minus 6 square is 36. That is equal to, what is that? 81 plus 81 plus 36. That is equal to root under 6 plus 1 is 7. 8 plus 3 is 11. 117. So 117, that means 13 into 9. 8117. So we will get 3 root 13. 3 root 13 unit. Now formula. Formula is area of a triangle. That is equal to half into base. You can take base is 2 root 13. 2 root 13 into 3 root 13. So 2 and 2 gone. So root 13 into root 13 is 13. 13 into 3 is 39. So you will get 39 square unit is your answer. So like this we have to